can we go further than line coverage? We sure can. After all, looking only at lines might not be enough when programs get more complicated. Take a look at this problem. We should count the number of words in a sentence that end with an S or an R. And we consider a new word to start when there is a non-letter character in the middle. For example, cat has 0 words. Cats has 1 word. Cats exclamation mark dogs has 2 words. Cats exclamation mark dog has 1 word, etc., etc. Although this problem might look simple, the implementation might need a few tricks. For example, while visiting the string, we should keep track of the last character we visited, so that as soon as we find something that is not a letter, we check if the last character was either an S or an R. As you can see, the if expressions we have there are quite complex, and they create a good number of different paths that our program can take, and this definitely requires some good testing. We can actually draw what we call a control flow graph to see the different paths, or as we also say, branches, that are possible in our implementation. In this graph, the yellow boxes represent decision points, meaning ifs, fors, etc. People usually use a diamond to represent these points, but to save some space, we are using simple yellow boxes. As you see, after every yellow box, we have 2 arrows. One points to where the program goes when the condition is evaluated to true, and the other one goes to where the program, where the condition is evaluated to false. Pause this video for a moment and take a look at this control flow graph. What could be better than lines of code as criterion here? A better criteria here would be to make sure we have at least 1 test for each branch, or for each arrow in the graph. Again, by branch, I mean a test that goes to the true path and a test that goes to the false path. For example, the big if we have, one of the tests should exercise the true path. In this one, the words plus plus is executed. Then another test should exercise the false path. In this one, the words plus plus is not executed. We then repeat it until all the branches are covered. Okay, let's get our hands dirty now and write a test that passes cats pipe dogs to the method count and asserts that there are 2 words, cats and dogs, of course. Take a moment to follow the execution of this test in the control flow graph. We see that after the string cats pipe, the left part of our control flow graph is already covered. Then after dogs, the other part is evaluated to true, which means we cover the true branch. Okay, almost there, but we still need to exercise the false branch, and this means we need 1 more test. That we can do if we pass cats pipe dog as an input. As dog, which is the last word in the string, doesn't end with an S or with an R, then the false branch will be executed. Nice, we just learned the concept of branch coverage. As you see, the idea is similar to line coverage. The difference is that we aim at exercising all the branches and not only lines. And we can also come up with a number that would measure our branch coverage. We can simply divide the number of branches our tests exercise by the total number of branches our program has. And there you go, we have our branch coverage. This is, in a way, very similar to the line coverage formula. The only difference is that now we count branches and not lines. But can we still do better? We will see each other in the next video.